This last week can be draining for runners. So how should you prepare? Dr. Barbara Walker is a sports psychologist and is here to help the runners who are coming into the home stretch. What should be their mindset as they head into this week?
Thanks for coming in, Dr.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely.
Their mindset should be very relaxed.
They shouldn't be thinking, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God.
Yeah, it makes my heart pound when you even say that. So they've done all the preparation they've really needed. So what they need to do is just make sure they have a very relaxing week. Stay around really nice people who are positive, making sure that they're moving slowly, doing all the things that they normally do. But one of the things they need to do is make sure that they get rest throughout the week, especially at nighttime, making sure that they sleep well the first few nights this week, because most people don't get a really good night's sleep, maybe a night or two nights before the marathon, so you want to make sure that you sleep well.
More rest now, than usual?
Not really more than usual, just making sure they get good rest. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
So as people head into this final stretch, any ideas about what kinds of foods they should eat or to prepare for the race?
Well, one of the things they should do is just eat what they've normally been eating. I mean, they've already put all the miles in the bank. So again, this week should just be a rest week. Not eating any more than they normally eat, but make sure that they don't try any new foods either. So that's something that some people do sometimes, and not even try any new clothes for the marathon. So make sure that you've worn everything, so everything's sort of set and planned and ready to go.
And I'm going to be a little selfish here. What if they happen to be coming down with a cold? What's a good way to get past that?
That's not the kind of doctor I am, but I truly making sure that they just take the vitamins that they need to take to make sure that they're resting and not stressing about this, making sure that they're having fun during the marathon and during this week because they've put a lot of miles in there.
And what's the best advice you can give somebody who's kind of experiencing some psychological difficulty, maybe some panic like you mentioned, maybe really feeling strange with this impending thing coming? What would you say to that person?
Yeah, well, truly, I mean, making sure that they're just staying nice and relaxed. I mean, I teach a lot of breathing in my office, so making sure that when they have like those little physiological feelings like heart palpitations, their belly might be having too many butterflies in there, just reminding themselves of why they're doing this, taking some deep breaths while they're doing that to be able to get some of that panic feeling out so that they can relax, because truly for the marathon, they need to make sure that they're hanging on to as much energy as they can, because at 26.2 miles is a lot of energy that they're going to be expending. So hanging on to that energy and not letting any of the nervous energy get away from them.
Okay, don't let any of your nervous energy get away here. Doctor, thanks.
Are you running?
Thanks for coming in.
I'm not the marathon, just
okay.
The relay.
So oh, just the relay is great. Absolutely.
That's
far. That's awesome.
For meteorologists.
Good. Yeah,
you
know. Great. Good.
All right, well, thanks for being here with us. And remember, if you can't make it down for all the marathon excitement, we'll have the coverage you need on race day Sunday, May 6th, next Sunday, starting at 5.